inside. Look inside your tiny mind, then look a bit harder.
Hello and welcome back to another edition to GSS Videos. I'm your host, Glenn Sam Sloan, hence the GSS, and videos is what I do. Alright, in this video it's going to just be about how I'm feeling at the moment, so you guys know. I'm not particularly happy. I'm happy when I'm talking to you guys, and right, because I feel that YouTube is a massive family, right? A big family amongst everyone else who likes producing videos and doing videos. Right? So we're a family, but we're not blood family, right? But I've got problems in my own life that are dragging me down. I've got problems with people that I care for and look to as our brothers and sisters, and who are my brothers and sisters, who are my family. Because things are going off in my own life, I can't unload on them. I don't think it's fair on them, right? I feel down, deflated. It's really sad. I'm feeling really down and depressed. Well, depressed, is it the right word? I don't know. I'm feeling down, deflated. Don't know which way I'm turning. It's like years ago, I was down, deflated, and yes, I felt like I was depressed. Then I felt like I was in, like I am now, I feel like I'm a big hole, I can't find my way out of things. Out of that big black hole. I feel like I'm at a crossroads and I don't know which way to turn. Do I turn left? Do I turn right? Or do I go straight ahead? Or why no, but I can't turn back. But in my past experiences of how I'm feeling, my past experiences, I realise now, my last experiences, I was depressed, because of what I was going through back then. I felt like down, deflated, didn't know which way I was going, up, do I turn left or turn right? So it's sort of, I'm in the right place, in the same place, but I don't know if I actually am at this moment. Last time I felt like this, I was so down, I was so deflated, I actually wanted to end it all. I wanted to end it all, but for instance, I was living in the place called Table Hill, in a one bedroom flat called number 8 that's closed in Haverhill in Suffolk. And I once sat down on my kitchen floor with the door shut, and I felt like I wanted to kill myself. I had two kitchen knives out. Well, I could easily reach, and I was thinking, do I or don't I? And when I was about to sort of end it, my mate Jamie from Suffolk, my mate Jamie Wilkie, who came down with his dad. And because his dad has his own health issues, I gave Jamie a key to number 8 last place, so his dad got somewhere to go to sit and rest, right, and gain some power, for some much needed rest that he can carry on with his day. But then, Jamie came in and saw that I've had these knives to my life, to my neck like that. Just as he walked in, I had my knives like, two kitchen knives like that. And I had them there firmly. He sort of didn't hesitate, but he came straight to me and got a hold of his knives and forced them away from my neck, forced them out of my hands, out of my clutches, of my hands. And stopped me. And after, he sort of wouldn't let me get out. He was trying to help me. So with that time, I appreciate what Jamie Wilkie was doing. Jamie was actually helping me. So thank you, Jamie. Thank you, Jamie Wilkie. You was a big help to me back then. I was a part of the British Red Cross in Haven Hill. And I was really down and depressed then, and I wanted to. I got home from work, and I worked at Sainsbury's. No one knew I was down, deflated, feeling low, feeling like I didn't matter, I didn't care, but my life was pointless. I just got out of my work uniform, and then walked down from where I was living to the Red Cross house with one of my old mates. I say old mates because he's not mate no more. It was just like a leech. He went off into the Red Cross house. I said, I'll be back, I'll be in a minute, mate, I'll be in a minute. But I didn't come in. I sat in the middle of the road, went into Janu, you know. End it. When people tried to approach me, I just got up and ran off. To get away from it, from them. I just didn't want to talk about it. I was so down and depressed. It was unreal. And that's what I was like when I was feeling down and depressed in Suffolk. But now I don't. It's not the same reason. It's a different reason. But I feel much the same, but not just with things that's going on through my own life, but things that's going off in other people's lives, people who I care for, people who I look to as brothers and sisters, and I just wish they see what I see, but they don't. I'm not going into detail on that. But I've got a lot of things going up, swimming around in my head, and I'm scared for them. I've got things going off in my own life, but again, I'm scared, and I've got those things swimming around in my head. Where am I going to go? Where am I going to end up? I don't know. And that really, really upset me. It's really upsetting me. Really, really upsetting me. And I would like to find out what is going on. I'm feeling down and sad. Feeling down, sad, deflated. But it's that. It's what I'm feeling now is, I felt down. Sad and depressed. I felt down, sad, deflated. It feels so different than now. So, but then, yes, I was depressed. But am I? I don't know if I am now, because yes, I feel down. Yes, I feel deflated. Yes, I feel sad. I've got things going off in my head. I wish I could talk about it, but I can't. It's really upsetting, really down and upsetting. might need to find a way to get back to feeling happy. But I can't feel happy. I can't feel up on the top of the world, because I'm not. I'm feeling down, deflated, let down. Where am I going to be? Where am I going to go? Where am I going to end up? I don't know. Please comment below and tell me what you feel or what you think of this video and how things was for you when you felt like this and what helped you. It would mean a big thing for me. It would really mean a lot to me. Please comment below. But I feel down and depressed. Don't know where I'm going to, where I'm going to end up. What? I just don't want to feel like this anymore. Like, just because my path is difficult doesn't mean I'm lost. No, it doesn't. Or does it? I don't know. Right. When my depression wins, I don't need to talk. I need someone to hug me, then sit with me and make me know that there's no place they would rather be than right there beside me. Sleep just isn't asleep. Sleep just isn't sleep anymore. It's an escape. At the moment, when I'm eventually going to sleep, and I'm waking up, I'm not waking up wide awake and ready to start the day. I'm waking up as in, oh God, do I have to get up today? Do I have to do this? Do I have to do that? And the problem is, yes I do. But I've got any motivation powers to just get up straight away. I have to force myself to get up. And what makes me get up is A, my dog, she needs me. Right, she needs me to let her out. She needs me to feed her. She needs me to love her, to care for her. Alright? And you guys. Alright? So, you guys, my subscribers, my viewers, my family, my best mates, my three best mates, and I don't need to mention your names, or don't I? Actually, I've got three best mates, but it's looking more like I've got four best mates. I'm really upset, really down, and it's really sad. I hate it when people tell me to just be happy, so you think I choose to be depressed. I can't describe what I'm feeling. I'm not happy, and I know that, but I'm also not exactly sad either. I'm just couldn't wait in between. Caught in between all those emotions and I feel so empty. Because I do. I don't know how to describe it. Well, I'm describing it as best as I can. I don't actually know how to describe it. Right. What I can say is what this picture's saying. I can't describe what I'm feeling. I'm not happy, and I know that, but I'm also not exactly sad either. I'm just caught right in between all those emotions. I feel so empty, because I do. I am caught in between emotions, and I do feel so empty. Because one minute I could be happy, jokey, talkative, and next minute I could be down, not wanting to do anything, not wanting to go anywhere, not wanting to do this, not wanting to do that. Right, so I don't know. Whatever said, words will never hurt me. You're right, words kill instead. I keep myself busy with the things I do, but every time I pause, I still think about you. And yes, there's things in my life, there's people in my life, right? I'm upset that they've got their problems, but I can't come to me and so I can help them. Because they're so like myself, they well a bit bottle it up and do things. But helps them. But I can't really go into that one either. But I'm keeping myself busy with doing YouTube videos and other things. I keep myself busy with things I do, but every time I pause, I still think about you. So, these one goes out to people who I care for, people who I look to as not just family, but people who I see as family. Here comes the sun, and I say, it's still night. The battle here comes. The battles here comes the sun. Right. What is depression like? He whispered. It's like drowning, except you can see everyone else breathing, everyone around you breathing. Yeah. With my past experiences, you're not alive. You're not alive. You're not this. You're not that. You're just existing. You don't know. You're not alive. You're not living. You're existing. Right. You feel like you're drowning, but you can see everybody else around you going on with their own lives, breathing and getting on with their own lives and being happy, and all you can feel is down, sad, tired, deflated. Sometimes when I say I'm okay, I want someone to look at me in the eyes, hug me tired and say, I know you're not. Fine. Right? How are you? Fine. That's how people feel. They don't feel down, deflated. That's how they feel. Fine. But they won't say what they really feel. You were the cause of myself depression. What was the cause of self depression? I don't know. Well, things are, I know. All I can see is a mist that comes against my eyes. I can't see the bigger picture. All I can see is that moment of tunnel vision. And I know I can do this. I know I can sort of step back and take a look at the bigger picture. At the moment, at this time in my life, I can't take that bigger picture. I know it will come to me. I know that I'll be able to, but when? All right. So I know I'll come through this, but I don't know when I will. And I just can't wait till that happens, because I'm so down and depressed. run down, so down, feeling so down, feeling deflated, feeling sad, even in my own life. The worst regret we can have in life is not for the wrong things we did, but for the thoughts of right things we did for the wrong people. I wanted to talk about it. Damn it, I wanted to scream. I wanted to yell. I wanted to shout about it, but all I could do was whisper, "I'm fine." Yeah, because I do actually want to talk about it, but I know I can't. I know I can't, because I'm frightened. As soon as I allow someone to get that close, that they'll walk all over me and do this and do that. It's so sad. Right? And then what this one? Dear heart, please stop getting involved in everything. Your job is to pump blood. That is it. I wish I could say that to my own heart, but I can't. I stopped fighting my inner demons. We're on the same side now. But are we on the same side? I don't know. I don't think we are. But I don't know. It'd only be on my own, on the same side if I get too badly down and deflated. Then I think then we'll be on the same side. But I'm still fighting them at the moment. This one, my boss. I'm tired, boss. Tired of being on the road, lonely as a sparrow. In the rain, I'm tired of never having me a buddy to be with, to tell me where we're going, to come, where we're going, to coming from, or why. Mostly, I'm tired of people being ugly to each other. I'm tired of all the pain. I feel and here in the world every day there's so much of it. It's like a piece of glass in my head all the time. Can you understand? I have to read that again because my dog started barking, made me jump. She made me laugh there. Thank you, Candy. I'm tired, boss. Tired of being on the road, lonely as a sparrow in the rain. I'm tired of never having me a buddy to be with, to tell me where we's going. To coming from, or why mostly I'm tired of people being ugly to each other. I'm tired of all the pain I feel and hear in the world. Every day there's so much of it. It's like a piece of glass in my hand. Sorry, not head, hand, all the time. Can you understand? Don't be so quick to judge you. Don't be so quick to judge you. Never know when you might just find yourself walking in that person's shoes. If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward. Martin Luther King, JR. Have you ever been so sad that it's completely hurt, possibly hurts inside? Yes, what now? And before, years ago. Faking a smile is so much easier than explaining why are you sad. Yes. Yeah. Yes, I have depression. No, I can't just get over it. You sometimes think you want to disappear, but all you really want is to be found. You were created to love and be loved. You were meant to live life in a relationship with other people, to know and be known. You need to know your story is important and you're part of a bigger story. You need to know your life matters. Yeah. And when someone is suffering from a horrible illness like cancer, you don't say to them, you don't say to them, you'd never say, you'd never say to them, it's only cancer, get over it. And this picture is saying just that. This picture is saying, you'd never say, it's just cancer, get over it. But people always tend to say, it's depression, get over it. But when you're suffering from depression, when you're suffering and you're feeling down and you're feeling deflated and you're feeling saddened, you can't just get over it. It's something that needs to be worked at. So yeah. I didn't want to wake up. I was having a much better time asleep, and that's really sad. It was almost like a river's nightmare. Like when you woke up from a nightmare, you're so relieved. I woke into a nightmare. Yeah, I was like asleep today. Right, I was asleep today, and then I woke up. Right, I was asleep today, and I thought I was in a nightmare, but no, I woke up. My days are a nightmare, but I can't sleep at the right time at night. Every thought is a battle, every breath is a war, and I don't think I'm winning anymore. Yeah? Every thought is a battle. Yeah, every thought is a battle. Every breath is a war, and I don't think I'm winning anymore. Yeah. Sad hurts, but it's a healthy feeling. It is a necessary thing to feel. Depression is very different. Which, yeah, sad is a healthy feeling. It's sad, it hurts, but it's still a healthy feeling. Right? But feeling depressed is a very different feeling, and you can't just get over it. When you're sad, but you can cheer up a lot easier. Right? But when you're down, deflated, feeling screwed up in the head, very feeling depressed. It is a very different kettle of worms. It is a very different kettle of fish. It is a different ball game, and you can't just get over it. And people who has not been through depression themselves in their life does not understand. Right? You can't just say to someone who's suffering from that, get over it. Right? You need to talk to them and make them realise that, hang on mate, I'm here for you, and I will be here for you all the time you need me. but who's going to be there? Who's going to actually stand up and speak up and say, hey mate, if you need me, I'm here for you. Alright? You are allowed, you are allowed to feel messed up and inside out. It doesn't mean you're effective. It just means you're human. That weak-willed moment when you think you're important to someone and you're not. The person is living in a body that fights to survive with a mind that wants, that tries to die. Yeah, the person is living in a body that fights to survive, but with a mind that just wants to die. Alright? I don't care. I don't feel depressed at this time, but I'm feeling down, sad, deflated. Is that depression? I don't know. Because I'm not feeling quite the same as I did back then, years ago. I'm feeling similar to it, but I'm not feeling the same. Right? What is depression? What is depression like? What do you think depression is like? It's like drowning, except you can see everyone else breathing. I am drowning. I'm drowning. I am drowning. I'm drowning because I want to help people. I want to help my mate. I want to help my mate. I want to help my best mates through their tough time. Right? And help my best mates through things that they can't, they're too blind to see for themselves. And I'm saying best mates, I'm actually talking about one of my best mates. They can't see something, they can't see at the moment because they're too close to in a certain circle. They can't see the wood through the trees, they can't see what they're doing. Right. It's going to harm them in the long run. And it's hurting me, because I can see it. Because I'm on that situation, I'm on the outside looking in, I can see it, right? But in my own circle, in my own little bubble here, in my own little circle, I can't see the width of the trees. I'm in the same sort of boat, but where I can see what he's going through or what they're going through, I'm only trying to help them if they allow me to. Allow me and let me help them. And it's upsetting. But me, I can't see the rhythm. I can't see it. I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know where I'm going to be from next minute, from one day to the next, from 1 month to the next, from 1 year to the next. I don't know when I'm going to come out of this. Depression is like a war. You are either win or die trying. I'm busy saving everyone else when I can't even save myself. I'm trying to save certain people from making the same sort of mistakes I used to make when I was living back where I was, where I'm from, mistakes that I've made myself in the past. Mistakes that I've made myself in the past and that they're now making themselves, but they can't see that I'm trying to help them, and I would love them to see, but they can't. I think it's actually winding me up, it's upsetting me now, so I think I've got to make a last bit here. Be better than you were yesterday. Be better than you were yesterday. It is said than done. Easy said than done. It is easy said than done. Because when you're down, when you're feeling down, when you're feeling depressed, when you're feeling deflated, when you're feeling saddened, or whatever you're feeling saddened, down, or depressed, deflated with, when you see that sentence, be better than you were yesterday. How can you be better than you were yesterday? You don't know what you're going to feel like from 1 minute to the next, let alone from 1 day to the next, from 1 year to the next, from 1 month to the next, bit, can you? So please text me, comment below, and tell me what your views are, or tweet me what your views are on this video, or Facebook message, comment what you, below what you think, because this video will be put up on YouTube and then shared to Facebook and shared to Twitter. So either tweet me, Facebook comment, or YouTube comment on this video. Thank you. Before I go, it's a lot easier to say you're mad than to admit how than admit you're hurt. It is. It's a lot easier to say you're mad than to admit you're hurt. Yeah, another thing is, before I go, right? Sick of crying, tired of trying. Yes, I'm smiling, but inside I'm dying. Another one. Hang on. It's hard to answer the question, "What's wrong?" when nothing's right. So when someone says to you, when you're feeling down, depressed, deflated, let down by whatever you're let down, you feel let down in, if someone says the question, "What's wrong?" how can you answer? Because you don't know. So it's hard to answer the question, "What's wrong?" when nothing's right. I can't answer it. When people say to me, "What's wrong with me?" I can't answer it because I don't know. In my own life, I can't answer my own problems because I don't know. I don't know where I'm coming, where I'm going. I don't know where I'm coming from. I don't know where I am at the moment. I feel down. I feel sad. I feel deflated. Sometimes I have dark thoughts. But it's upsetting, right? And I'm trying to help other people, but I can't, right? So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I don't know what I am actually gonna do. So until the next time, I say farewell, my friends, and speak to all laters. Okay. So until the next time. And until next time, have a good day, have a good week, have a good month. Right? Please keep tuned, because I will be back. Why I'm still fighting, how I'm feeling, because being here talking to you guys is keeping my mind off it, of what I'm feeling, and you guys are actually helping by watching these videos, by clicking that subscribe button, by liking my videos. So if you haven't not yet subscribed, please click that subscribe button, turn my notifications on, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Facebook, follow me on Instagram. I'm trying to get up on to Snapchat as well, so follow me on Snapchat when you see me, that is. But I don't know if I'm on there. I'm not on there just yet, but keep a lookout for me. Alright? But yeah, please keep tuned, because I will be back. But please bear with me. I'm not feeling so happy at the moment with my own life, what things going on. So yeah. So it's a bit annoying how some people think that not worthy of their time. I'm not worthy of them even talking to us. I'm not worthy of this. I'm not worthy of that. Because, let's face it, all I've ever done is look out for people. All I've ever done is respect people. And what I've done is try to look out for people who I care for, people I look for, look out for as brothers, sisters, family members, right? And if I care for someone as a brother, I care for someone as a sister, or as a family member, that means I care for you. And when I'm saying I care for you, and when I say I love you as a brother, or I love you as a sister, or as a family member, right? Don't assume I'm just saying it, because I'm not. I mean it. Right? You know what? I love my YouTube family. And you guys are my YouTube family. Right? So, you guys are my YouTube family. So I love you to bits, you're my YouTube family. And without you, I wouldn't be where I am today. So I will be back. Please stay tuned. Right? So until the next time, farewell my friends. Have a good night, have a good week. Have a good day, have a good night, have a good week. Good month. Right, until the next time, I'll say farewell my friends, and bye-bye.